Let's get to our strategy session right now. Joining us, our CNN contributor, the Democratic strategist Hilary Rosen and Republican strategist John Feehery. Guys, thanks very much for coming in. Now, we're seeing a little bit softer side of Mitt Romney out there on the campaign trail yesterday and today, telling personal stories that we really haven't heard him do in the past. Let me play a little clip.
So I put my hand on his shoulder and I reached over and I said, Billy, I love you and God bless you. It was a great occasion to say hi to my good friend, and he passed away the next day. And I thought, what a blessing it was for me to see him on that last day and acknowledge to him my respect for him.
Why do you think, John, he's doing this? Because in the past, he really hasn't opened up personally like that. Very emotional story.
I think there's been a caricature of Mitt Romney, and I think he's trying to expose people to who he really is. I think there's been some reluctance to talk about his religious faith. I think now that's kind of... We're getting closer to the end of the election. I think it's time for people to understand that he's actually a really nice guy, really good guy. All these caricatures that are out of him are not accurate. And I think that when people have a more fulsome view of who Mitt Romney is, I think people want to vote for him.
You're an excellent strategist. What do you think about this new strategy?
I think it's nice. I mean, good for Mitt Romney. I think it's smart for him to do.
Does it impact voters out there see a little softer side?
I think it not only impacts voters, I think it energizes him clearly. I mean, I think that since the debate, we've kind of seen a new Mitt Romney, and President Obama's clearly got to up his game in terms of the enthusiasm, in terms of the fighting for the American people. I think the policies are on the president's side. You know, when you poll the issues that the president stands for and that Mitt Romney stands for, people actually know that the president is on their side more than Mitt Romney is in terms of the middle class, but... You know, Mitt Romney is trying harder right now in people's minds.
And he seems to be a little bit more confident after that first presidential debate. There's another debate, as all of us know, Thursday night, vice presidential debate. The vice president, Joe Biden, will face Paul Ryan, his Republican challenger. Listen to Paul Ryan speaking to one of our affiliates, WTMJ. Listen to this.
We think he's probably going to come at me like a cannonball. Mm-hmm. More pressure because Mitt Romney put such a great performance at the bar is pretty high. There's also pressure because Joe Biden's been doing this for 40 years. I mean, the man ran for president twice. He's a sitting vice president. This is my first time on this kind of a stage. So, sure. Yeah, there's a lot of pressure. Joe Biden's very experienced at this. And I think that's right. Because of the lack of momentum they have, because of the president's terrible performance, because Mitt Romney did such a good job of getting the country a choice, I don't think they have any choice but to have Joe Biden come right at me.
Hillary.
Yeah, I think there is pressure on Joe Biden to deliver a big performance. But I actually think there's more pressure on Paul Ryan, because there were so many times in the debate where Mitt Romney kind of changed the facts from the policies he said, whether it was how he's going to make his tax cut revenue neutral, whether he's going to whether the president's Medicare proposal is actually a cut in Medicare. Paul Ryan was the chair of the House Budget Committee. It would be an affront to him not to have accurate, factual details on these issues the way that Mitt Romney got away with.
He's a very wonky kind of guy. Paul, those of us who know Paul Ryan have seen him over the years. He knows numbers, statistics, stuff like that.
He does. And you know, it's interesting because it's a generational divide. You have the two Irish Catholics, one older, one younger, one caring about the future of the country economically and fiscally, the other kind of keeping the traditional Democratic philosophy out there. So I think it'll be a good debate. Joe Biden has been at this for many, many years. This is really Paul Ryan's first rodeo. So I do think that there's pressure on both of them. I think, you know, in many ways, though, the vice presidential debate doesn't mean much. I mean, if you think about the biggest blowout in history was Lloyd Bentsen against Dan Quayle. I mean, George Bush still won. So I'm not sure how much it means. I think it's going to be interesting. I think there's a little bit of pressure on both of them, but I don't think it's going to change the dynamics.
It could mean something is, you know, there's been this, for lack of a better word, the kind of back and forth within the press and within the candidates' campaigns about this tax cut, whether you actually can achieve the balanced budget that Mitt Romney's promising. I think he's making a lot of false promises. It'll be interesting to see whether the vice presidential debate actually sheds light on that and whether it moves the issue forward in any significant way for
people. From my perspective, I think that Paul Ryan has been having to sell this plan for a long time because he's in a district that's, you know, marginally Republican, but pretty Democrat. So he's got to go out and sell it, and he's been able to sell it. And I think that he's going to be more effectively able to sell it than anybody else.
But Biden has done these national debates.
Sure, yes.
Ryan hasn't, so this is a big challenge for the much younger Republican vice presidential nominee. This new Pew Research Center poll generating a lot of buzz out right now. I'll put the numbers once again on the screen right now. After all of this taken after the debate, do you see Romney ahead 49-45% before the debate September 12th through September 16th? Obama ahead 51-43%. There's a lot of debates, polls, accurate snapshots. We want to see more polls. We want to see state polls. But this could be a jolt to the if other polls back this up, Hillary, this will be a jolt to the Obama campaign.
Yeah. Now it's the Democrats' turn to talk about how polls don't matter, right?
We're already hearing about the number of Democrats versus
Republicans. Should we argue about the numbers and the methodology and all that stuff? Look, I just have always thought that this was going to go right down to the wire. I think we clearly have a close election here. You know, over the next few days, seeing what some of these individual battleground states are doing, because some of those polls are going to come out in the next few days, will have maybe more meaning than the national poll. But look, there's no question that the American people are looking to President Obama now to fight a little harder for him and to get a little more.
Let me show the Gallup aggressive tracking poll numbers as well, because these are over the past 7 days. Half of this poll was done before the debate, some afterwards. If you add them all up, you see 50 to 45. But right now, in the last few days, it's been narrowed to 47-47 since the debate. So clearly the Republican, John, has gotten a little bounce out of this.
First of all, I agree with Hillary. I don't think these polls mean that much except for establishing a narrative. And the narrative now that's being established is Mitt Romney is coming back after his great debate performance, and that gives more enthusiasm to the Republicans, and it makes the Democrats feel, you know, a little bit off their game, a little bit less enthusiastic. And I think you see that in other polls. So we'll see what happens. I think mostly at the end of the day, what matters is how well you turn out your voters. We all know it's going to be a close election, and whoever has the best turnout operation.
Because that ground game, especially in Ohio and Florida and Virginia, Colorado, that ground game, the Republicans were very good at it 2 years ago, as you well remember.
Yeah, and I feel really good about where the Obama organization is. More volunteers than ever are coming forward. And look, for the last couple of elections, whoever won the first debate did not win the election. I think voters really will see where President Obama is on their side, that we just had a good jobs report. We have 31 months of straight employment growth. I think, you know, we are definitely trending right.
I think that people want to change. I think they want a better economy in the future, and they want a vision for the future, which they're not getting from President
Speaking
Obama.
Speaking about a vision for the future, congratulations to you.
Thank you very much.
I know, that's
so
nice.
The Feehery family has a new sweet color.
Molly Kate, she came in at 7 pounds, 14 ounces. Mom and Molly are at home right now, and they're very
healthy. Are they watching, you think?
I think Molly's watching every
Molly, step. I'm sure she loves the situation.
She loves it. She watches it every day.
Let's get a picture. We'll tweet it.
For every 6 days she's been alive.
Congratulations.
Thank you.